Carolina Mountains is Kid Brewer Stadium, The Rock, home to the Appalachian State Mountaineers, and Boone is ready for this one. And boy, do we have a fun one ahead. Top 10 team, target on their back, going on their road and right into the snake pit. As we'll see, the number 3 team in the country, the West Virginia Mountaineers, taking on a squad hoping to prevent another L this week, the Appalachian State Mountaineers. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. And guys, can't wait to get this one started. And the Mountaineers will boot it away to start the game. On the run from inside his own 5. And they'll haul down the returner to start us on the next drive. So West Virginia's offense takes the field for the first time today. Here he comes, and any time this guy touches the ball, and he will touch it plenty, a bolt of electricity just goes through the stadium, David.
And they'll feature him. They'll give him the ball, like you said, a lot, early, often. And he's a guy that can make game-breaking plays. The offense is built around his ability to run the football, Jesse, make big plays for this offense.
Yeah, he really shoulders the load, right, in more ways than one. The offense goes as this guy goes. So what's going to be important in this one, they get him going early and often.
Still on his feet at the 45. And that one looked as if it might go all the way, but they picked up more than 40 yards before the touchdown saving tackle. They had hoped to come up with explosive plays, and they used one there to set him up inside the 30, first and 10. Fires to the wideout. He's got an open man. Touchdown, Mountaineers! Made the snag and strolled his way into the end zone. And he's got the extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. Quick strike offense on that 3-play scoring drive. And they finished the deal with a 26-yard touchdown pass. 7-0. He'll bring it out. That is a decision he will likely regret. He brings it out of the end zone, and he's knocked down at the 10. So the App State Mountaineers offense will go to work for the first time today. And you want to talk about dudes who can bring the heat off the edge, David? Both of these teams have somebody that can do just that.
That's so much fun. They get off the rock, and they get in the backfield and get to quarterbacks. Make them feel uncomfortable, get them to the ground. These guys change the way offenses are playing the game.
These offensive coordinators better help out their quarterback. These guys need to be double-teamed with tight ends and running backs. You let these guys go one-on-one, you're asking to get sacked.
Grab behind the line. It's Sanders. Makes the grab, and it's enough for the first down before he's dragged to the ground. The Mountaineers are in the hurry up.
And a great job by the QB finding the running back, getting the football where he can do some damage after the catch. And most.
And the quarterback caught up to and sacked at the 12.
A loss of 8 yards on the play.
So they'll try to salvage this drive on second and long from the 12. He'll keep it himself. That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there.
Yeah, and it's a nice job by this defense. Understand, listen, that QB is a threat. And they're going to run all kinds of options, and he's going to run the football. They were dialed in and got that sucker to the ground.
And sure, tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker.
Coming up.
And the Mountaineers will punt this one away. The punter going to get his first work of the afternoon. Makes a move. They were playing with fire on that return, and he got loose for a good return of better than 30 yards. West Virginia has it in the offense ready to go to work. Leaves it with the back. Got some room in it to the goal line. And he'll finish the run in the end zone. Touchdown, West Virginia.
This offense is so good. Man, they can hurt you in so many different ways. And they do it so quick, so explosive. They can put small drives together, big drives together. They've really had a great year. And that's why they're a top 10 offense.
Coming out with it, it's Sanders. I imagine he's going to get an earful on the sideline after bringing it out of the end zone and being knocked down at the 11. Opening play of this drive comes from the 11. They'll go to the ground. Determined run, but he stopped after 2 yards down at the 13. Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. On the run, it's Wall. Weaves his way ahead and gets 5 out to the 18-yard line. So third and short from inside the 20. You convert here, and this drive takes on a different complexion. They'll try to pick it up on the ground. And boy, is he close to that first down, maybe just a couple of inches short. The Mountaineers line up to punt it away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. On the move, looking for a little sliver of hope. This guy is a daring punt return man. He's not going to settle for the fair catch. A solid return gets a little bit of ground for the offense. West Virginia has it back, ready to dive into that playbook. Here's the handoff. Puts him in the spin cycle. On the move at the 30. And he'll take it in. They couldn't get him on the ground. Touchdown, Mountaineers! These guys are really hitting their stride in week 4 as they push out that lead. And with the extra point, they're up 21 to nothing. What a way to send a message. Huge play in the running game. One snap, and you've got a touchdown on the board. Out of the end zone. I imagine he's going to get an earful on the sideline after bringing it out of the end zone and being knocked down at the 11. This drive will commence from their own 11-yard line. Off the play fake on first down. And the pressure gets him back at the 8-yard line.
Man, this defense has been so impressive to watch. Look at him get to the quarterback, get the sack. They play so fast. It's like they have 12 men on the field. Another good performance going down right now, coming off of last week, putting a goose egg on the board against their last opponent.
A first down sack can be a drive killer. Now it's second and 13. He's looking to throw, extending the play. And now the ball's loose in the end zone. And the defense got it. And not much else could go wrong. A defensive touchdown as they keep piling it on. That ball was squirting around on the field, finally corralled by the defense, and they turn it into 6.
And it's so hard defensively. Do I jump on it and make sure I get it, or do I scoop it up and try to make the big play? He chose to scoop it up, and it pays off, makes the big play, gets the touchdown.
And the coverage team gets the returner on the ground. Appalachian State regains possession, and the Mountaineer offense headed to the field. Off the play fake on first down to throw. He'll pull it down and run. Good little pickup there as he saw some daylight and got what he could.
It's just so nice to have a QB under center nowadays in football. You can trust these guys. You put so much on their plate, and you tell them, go get positive yards when it's there. And a lot of these guys are such great athletes, they do it with ease.
They'll run the screen. And they wrap him up, but not before he gets enough on the catch for the first down.
I like the running back there on the route, the patience he showed, really setting it up. He got to the defender, was able to put his foot in the ground, get some separation, catch it, and turn upfield for the first.
Fires to the right. Incomplete, and he threw that one up for grabs and into traffic, fortunate to get it back.
And that's why these guys played defense. If that were an offensive player or receiver, that would have easily have been a catch. Come on, man. You've got to catch that and make that a pick.
From the gun, running back on the move. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
Well, just nothing doing on that last run, and they knew coming into this one they were going to be challenged, right? This is one of the best defenses in all of college football. For them to have any shot, they're going to have to do a lot better running the football.
And the defense is there to stop him short of the first down. And the Mountaineers will send out the punt unit.
Number 13 in punt formation to kick it away.
No fair catches here, looking for room. And he'll work his way on the return out to the 35-yard line before he stops. West Virginia has it in the offense ready to go to work. Looking for a productive play on first down. Wide out in motion. One back in the backfield, and they'll give it to him. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Offense gets set for second down. Looking for space. It's Turner. Oh, better look out. And he breaks into the open. He's at the 10. And he'll take it all the way. They couldn't bring him down. Touchdown, Mountaineers.
Hey, coming into the game, you look at the stats and you say top 10 offense in scoring. So they better be able to create what? Explosive plays. Another explosive plays. They've been doing it all year long. Those plays are backbreakers. Defenses just can't contain this offense.
Ready to try the point after. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. Guys, that's the end of the quarter, and West Virginia has the lead. Really strong performance so far to be able to build a lead here in the first period as we look at the stats. They largely dominated the first quarter and built a nice lead to get started. Kickoff team is on the field. They'll try to drive this one deep. Here he comes from inside his own five. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. The Appalachian State offense returns to the field. Power football with the run. That hole closed quickly, a pickup of one to the 15.
The offensive coordinators out there going, thank goodness we don't play them every week. This defense has been suffocating. This offense got to find something moving forward that they can hang their hat on, some kind of identity. Today they were shut down, but listen, there's a game next week, right? Like, got to continue to find what it is that makes this team go, that makes them tick, that makes them get first downs and hopefully move the football.
Now facing a third and long. From the gun, wants to pass. Unloads it left. Fires into traffic. Intercepted.
I'll tell you what, defensive players don't always see where the ball is. They see the receiver and they get to chase him, but really good job seeing where the receiver is, going and making an interception, making a big play, getting the ball back to your offense.
He wants to start this drive with a pass. Makes the grab on the left. Stopped after making the catch.
And quarterback receiver on the same page. Nice job seeing the zone, understanding the drag route concept. Easy pitch, easy catch.
Jukes his way for more. Brought down to the ground, but he has enough for the first down. From the 22 on first and 10. Jackrabbit. Use the play fake, now to throw. Looking to the big tight end. Makes the grab. Gets it inside the five, down to the four, and it'll be first and goal. Defense is backed up. Shadow of the goal post trying to defend their own end zone. And he takes it to the house. Touchdown, West Virginia. Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point just tacks a little bit more onto this huge lead. Quick work on that scoring drive, just four plays. And they finish it off with the score from the four. On the move from inside is five. And the returner goes down. Appalachian State regains possession and the Mountaineer offense headed to the field. Mistakes are going to happen, as they did on that last drive. Now, how will they respond, Jesse?
And this is the kind of guy who's going to take full accountability. That was my bad. That's on me. I'm about to lead this offense now down the field and score some points.
Dang, Palmer. I wish I would have played with you. I didn't play with many quarterbacks that were just like, yeah, my bad. Hey, guys, I got this. Sorry about that. It was more. Should have ran a better route.
Well, the good news is he did a nice job reading the coverage. He knew exactly where to go with the football that time. Just a little bit too much on that pass. You wonder if that's just nerves. got to settle himself down a little bit.
Unloads to the wideout. Ball in the air, intercepted. Couldn't find much room on the return, but what a costly miscue, and they've got it at the 26-yard line.
And this is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. Two interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision making.
And the defense finally makes the stop after the sweet run and good gain.
There's really no secret to it, David. When this guy's running well, this offense is so hard to stop.
It opens up everything, and he's having a great day, showing you a little bit of everything, and this offense has got it rolling on the ground.
And he sprints to the end zone. Touchdown, Mountaineers! Well, just as you would expect, that didn't take very long.
It didn't, Reese. You've got to make great field position count. When you've got opportunities, you got to pay it off. And the offense took advantage, scoring a touchdown. Didn't have far to go, but they got the points they needed.
He'll bring it back from inside his five. And the return man reaches the end of the line, and down he goes. The Appalachian State offense returns to the field. After throwing the pick on the last drive, need to take care of the ball this time, Jesse.
We're going to find out a lot about this quarterback right here, too. How does he fight through adversity after that last drive?
Yeah, clear the mechanism, move on. That's a part of it. Like, if you're going to be a great player, you got to learn how to handle these mistakes and move on.
After the productive first down play, it's second and six. Right back to him on the ground. Ball is free. Defense just cradling that fumble and securing it. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own. Couldn't order better field position for this offense. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him. Got enough space. Touchdown, Mountaineers. And they add six more to the board with that trip to the house. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive.
West Virginia, 56, App State, 0.
He'll start the return inside his five. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. Appalachian State regains possession, and the Mountaineer offense headed to the field. As it turns out, the fumble on that last drive set up the touchdown, David.
And there's no bigger stat in football than turnovers. You turn the football over, they turn it into points. Jesse, that is not a recipe for success.
Good news, though, they get another chance, right? They can make amends with this drive right here. That's all that's important. You've got to execute, and you've got to lock in.
Give to the running back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one. This defense has kept them backed up. Now one more stop, and they can get off the field on third and long. From the gun, wants to pass. Lofts one deep down the right side. And it's picked off for the third time today. Bringing it back. He steps out of bounds, but not only does he get the ball back, what a return to set up his offense. The explosive play set the table. Now they got to serve. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, West Virginia. They'll try to add another to their lead. The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown.
West Virginia, 63, App State, 0.
And he takes this from inside the five. And they'll bring him down to get the offense started on the next drive. They've got a little time here to put together a productive drive late in the half. Snags a quick pass on the left. And a big hit at the end, but it didn't stop him from getting the first down. First down here with time for maybe one more play until the two-minute warning. We've reached the two-minute warning, and this thing has been one-sided, and they hope to at least have something to feel good about going into halftime. He'll come out throwing on first down. Buys a little extra time. And the quarterback was trying to extend the play, and the defense brought it to a close. The Mountaineers want to pick up the tempo. On second down, wants to throw it. Escapes, and the ball comes out. What a disastrous play. Defense covering it up and not letting the offense get it back. It's a turnover. This offense has been running up and down the field, and here they are, first and goal, a chance to tack on another one before halftime. Fires into the end zone, and he's got it. Touchdown, Mountaineers. The AT unit on the field. And with that extra point, the lead remains in the gargantuan category. That's taking advantage of a golden opportunity set up with great field position, and they struck quickly for the touchdown. On the run from inside his own five. And good work by the coverage team to knock down the return man. The Appalachian State offense returns to the field. Boy, they've been caught in a buzzsaw here in the first half, but maybe a chance to carry some momentum into the... And this sophomore able to wreak some havoc and get the sack.
And after that last sack, man, you could just see it. They are feeling themselves. After pitching a shutout last week, after dominating early in this game, just seems like they're...
And the ball's free. The offense back on top of it. That's going to be a safety, but trust me, that could have been much, much worse. The kickoff team lined up. They'll have to give it back after giving up that safety.
The return brings it out to the 49, and the West Virginia offense.
The offense set for a first down play. Use the play fake. Now to throw. Trying to get behind the defense. And he gets the foot down. It's a catch deep along the left sideline.
I love when you back the defense off of you. If you want to get aggressive, I'll take shots down the field. Make the defense play more conservative.
Throws toward the end zone. And it's caught. Touchdown, Mountaineers. Climbing up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. This offense prides itself on going after you, and they did with that long touchdown pass to finish off a two-play drive. Here he comes from inside his own five. And the returner could find no daylight. He goes down. Appalachian State regains possession, and the Mountaineer offense headed to the field. This late in the half, you're behind. You'd love to create something before the break to build momentum, Jesse.
But you've also had some miscues on offense, a big part of why you're losing the game right now. I'd take it into halftime, make my adjustments, and come out ready in the second half.
Yeah, I'm going to take it into halftime too, Palmer. But I'm trying to put some points up right here. Be aggressive, set the tone, be like, hey, listen, this is what you're going to get.
And here's a fumble way behind the line. Oh, looks like the offense was able to recover it. There's a timeout called as this offense tries to find a way to draw a little closer. This offensive line has just been unable to keep them away from the quarterback. Now it's second and long. Grabbed over the middle. It's Wall. They bring him down, but a solid pickup to put them in position to pick up a first down. And the Mountaineers in the hurry up. On third and long, try to convert through the air. Well, the quarterback can make a big play when he starts moving around. He'll be brought down, and that's the final play of the half. That's the end of the second quarter. That means it's time to join Kevin in our halftime update.
Guys, it is hard to beat Boone when that town is buzzing as it is today. And it'd be easy to say these two offenses are glad we've hit halftime based on their respective performances. It would also be accurate. Turnovers and sacks have told the story so far. And you gotta believe the play calling has been the issue, right? Time to shred those game plans and just get back to basics. And with that, let's send it back to the fellas at Kid Brewer Stadium.
move from inside his five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Appalachian State offense returns to the field. What could go wrong did in the first half, and they start this third quarter at the bottom of the mountain.
Man, that was bad. That was a frying pan to the head. That was a TKO. It was awful in the first half. Flush it. I got to start doing something right. I got to find some positives. I get the ball first to start this possession, try to put a scoring drive together.
The only thing you can do at this point offensively is just make sure your best players are touching the football as often as possible. You recruited these guys, you got guys out of the portal, you put your faith in them to make plays. This is a time to go out and do it.
Holding penalties, the ultimate drive killer. We'll see if it costs this offense here. They'll line up for a second down play. And the defense holds firm. No pickup at all on that play. Not exactly the ideal situation for this offense. Third and long, backed up inside their 20. Feeling some heat. Now improvising. And he is corralled short of the line to gain.
It's a little demoralizing, too, I think, if you're on defense, because it looked like you had him, right? It's third down. Everybody's getting ready for a big sack. They're pinning their ears back trying to get upfield. You just can't make the play. Quarterback's able to escape. He doesn't get the first down, but he did get nice yardage, so I'm curious to see what they do here on fourth.
West Virginia has it back, ready to dive into that playbook. First down for this offense. The give to the tailback. And a 9-yard gain on first down leaves him with second and short. They'll run it from the gun. Slam to the ground, but not before he gets the first down.
Man, those little chunks keep annoying the crud out of you when you're on defense. It's just putting them in easy situations, chewing up 4 to 6 yards at a pop like that.
Looking for the end zone. Fires into traffic, picked off.
That's the advantage right there of having your dime personnel on the field. You've got an extra DB. You've got an extra guy out there who's really good at covering. So for quarterbacks, you've got to be so good and precise with these passes because they've got speed in the back end. They're able to come away with the pick.
Appalachian State regains possession and the Mountaineer offense headed to the field. Wants to throw on first down off the play fake. And he's all bottled up, and now it's worse. The ball's loose. Defense coming up with a huge fumble recovery. Touchdown, West Virginia. The defense takes matters into their own hands. And with the extra point, they push the lead out a little further. The scoop and score, what a lift it can give to the defense. Not content to get the ball. They wanted to do something with it, and they did. He'll bring it back from inside his five. And good work by the coverage team to get the return man down on the ground. First down here for the offense. The give on the inside. Not much there. They'll give him one to the 14.
And a lot of times you want those big plays. You want those splash plays. But sometimes you're going to take some losses. You're not going to run the football overly well. But if you continue to run it, you can at least create some balance. You at least have the threat of it. Otherwise, you're just going to abandon it, and now it's just going to be a passing game.
Four punts already, and they've got to convert here to avoid a fifth.
I know the passing game sells and the passing game is exciting, but it's not exciting to get 5 or 6 yards a pop on the ground, but it will be very successful.
That pass is well off target. He got hit as he was trying to throw, and they can't convert on third down. And the Mountaineers will punt it away on fourth down. They may have to pay him overtime. He's punting for the fifth time today. He only needs a sliver of daylight. Score! Touchdown, Mountaineers! He did that one all by himself. Make a few guys miss, turn on the afterburners, and boom, everybody's toast.
And that's why you got him back deep, because that guy can do that. You got to be explosive and quick and have good vision, and you see all those things on one punt return. Takes it back to the house, makes people miss, turn it on the gas. Great job, great return.
The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. Let's go to the studio now and check in with Kevin Connors. Kevin, what do you got?
A bit of an under-the-radar game this week, guys, but take a look at this. New Mexico State is ahead in this one. This team plays a hard-nosed brand of football there in Las Cruces, but they're a long way from closing this out. They're up by a field goal over UTEP. We'll circle back. If anything big happens, you should know about it.
Thanks for the update on that one. Kevin, let us know when it goes final. Caught in the backfield. It's Wall. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there.
Yeah, and you see running backs in today's football. They play a wide receiver basically for you, but you got to find a guy that you can throw it to, and you know he's going to catch the ball consistently.
Another interception. That's his fourth of the day.
And this safety is a ball hawk. He's a playmaker. Not only have we seen him get involved in the running game and make tackles playing downfield, but he plays the center field position as well as anybody in college football, and you saw it right there.
Got some room, headed to the goal line. Touchdown, Mountaineers. And the pummeling has started. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. That's exactly what you want to do when you have that type of field position. Strike quickly, and they did. One play, and they put it on the board. He'll start the return inside his five. And the returner will be dragged down. The Appalachian State offense returns to the field. Hold and fired complete.
I love offenses and quarterbacks that are willing to take the easy stuff. Take those easy throws that are guaranteed to get positive yards. Yeah, I'm going to take big shots down the field too. But don't forget, it's easier to pick up second and five, third and five, than it is when we start getting those long yardage situations.
Grab near the sticks. It's Stevens. He is tackled, but it'll be a fresh set of downs. Offense has it at the 28 on first down. Used the play fake. Now to throw. Moving out of the pocket. He's going to take off. Able to get just a few before sliding to avoid the hit. Second down coming up.
Well, they go with the bootleg, and it works that time. You saw the defensive end came crashing down the line of scrimmage. He was sold on the fact that the running back was going to have the ball. So nice job with the ball fake by the Q. And then he's able to use that speed to get outside. Nice positive play.
Yeah, and it's been a surprise today for this offense. Like, coming into the game, we all talked about it. We thought they'd be able to run against this defense that's been run on a lot, and this offense just can't get the running game going.
And the defense is all over the quarterback, and down he goes. The Mountaineers will call on their punt team. And these guys have been busy. Sixth punt of the day. Takes it on the return. He's got great speed. Oh, what a move. Really explosive when he gets his hands on the ball, and he found a couple of crevices and made a nice gain before being run out of bounds. West Virginia has it, and the offense ready to go to work. The give out of the gun. And how about the efficiency on that one? It'll bring up second and four. Tried to pound it on first down, now back to the line. From the shotgun, the inside give. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior. From the 36, a third down, and you wonder if they're willing to take two plays to get the first. The play action fake. Throws to the wideout. And it's incomplete on third down.
Third and short in college football today, you see so much more pass than you used to. The offense stays aggressive, and I think they stay aggressive because they know they're in field goal range. They got that three in their back pocket.
Got it past the marker. And he's knocked down, but not before moving the chains. Offense getting set for first down. making sure they have good balance, keeping it on the ground. And he's brought down after a solid gain, and that'll be the final play of the third quarter. Guys, that's the end of the quarter, and West Virginia has the lead. This has been a complete obliteration so far, as the third quarter stats will show you. So will the beatdown continue, or is this a comeback for the ages in store? We'll see as we start the fourth. They can really be aggressive after that last play. It's second and three. And he's brought to the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down.
Well, the defense knew coming into this one it was going to be a physical game. Guys are going to have to be great at the point of attack and get off blocks and make tackles. They couldn't stop the offense from picking up that first down on that run play.
They'll give it to the back. Nice move to keep running. They get him on the ground. He picked up about 4 yards, and the ball spotted at the 10. Second down coming up on this red zone opportunity. They've got him looking run, but they're going to throw it. He makes a grab. Goes out of bounds, but they'll be set up with a first and goal. The big fellas line up in a goal line defense. Trying to barge their way in. Good, solid tackle. See if they can get it done on second and goal. Trying to punch it in. Touchdown, West Virginia. And the beatdown has ensued. They give themselves a little more cushion as they try to reel off their fourth straight win. And the extra point was good. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. Looking for those open spaces and opportunity. And the returner will be brought down. Appalachian State regains possession, and the Mountaineer offense headed to the field. To the air on first down. Now he's going to break the pocket.
Well, you're making a positive out of a negative. And that time, quarterback, nice job, buying time. He's trying to throw the football downfield. Nothing there, so instead of throwing it away, getting the incomplete, just get what you can get and make this next down more manageable.
Looking to scramble. He'll try to do it himself. He's brought down, but not before he turned that into a positive play and picked up a few on the run. Pinned just inside their own 20, they need to convert on third and short. From the gun, wants to pass. Steps away. The freshman able to get home with the sack. And the Mountaineers will line up to punt it away.
Number 13, on to punt it away.
At midfield, trying to turn it upfield. Man, oh man, did that coverage team have its hands full. Well, not full, because they didn't get a hand on him for quite a while. Great return there. West Virginia has it back, ready to dive into that playbook. They'll pick up four, second and six coming. It'll be second down, and remember, they can pick up a first without scoring. They'll keep it on the ground. The clock is on their side. Obliterates him, still on the move. He pushes his way down to the four as they get closer and closer.
It's hard to stop great runners. It really is. That's why you run the football consistently. You got a big offensive line, a big physical unit. You run the football like this, man, it will take a toll later. But you got to tackle this guy over and over again, who has this ability to make people miss.
Touchdown, Mountaineers! And the punishment has been extended. With that, the lead nice and comfortable, and they're cruising toward a 4-0 start.
Man, this has been a complete performance. The defense has been lights out, and the offense, obviously, just continues to pour it on. This is what you call having a great day. Putting it all together, offense, defense, complimentary football.
Good job by the coverage unit to stop the return man. The Appalachian State offense returns to the field. Trying to find his man on first down. Looking down the middle. He's got it. He'll be stopped at the 27, but it's a 15-yard gain. They'll put in play from the 27. First down. He wants to throw. Catch in the middle. It's Johnson. And a good job of coverage by that defense. Just a short pickup.
This quarterback right now is in a groove, and he's doing a nice job in pre-snap. He's reading the coverage, and he's getting an idea of where he wants to go with the football. That's why the ball's coming out of his hands so quickly. That's why he seems like he's in a great rhythm.
And he's going to lose yardage. He was looking everywhere for just a little grass and a little air, and none to be found. Third and long, and he'll try to throw for it. Trying to make magic with his feet. And he avoids the tackle with the slide. We hit the two-minute warning, and this offense is desperate to make something happen and do it in a hurry. Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Working his way on the return up to the 40-yard line before he stopped. West Virginia has it in the offense ready to go to work. With this big cushion they're working with, Jesse, they're ready to send these fans toward the exits.
And you know the coaching staff has got to be so...
Oh, look out! He's at the 20. And they're going to put another one into the end zone as they just keep piling points on the scoreboard.
With that last touchdown, it looks like they're going to start this season 4-0, and you've got to be impressed with what you've seen so far from this team. We knew coming in on paper this team had a chance this season, but until the lights go on, until you actually go out and do it for real, you can't believe just how good they are. But they've shown now, starting 4-0 on the year, this is a team that's going to contend for a national championship.
The offense lining up for a first down play. He's looking to throw it, using his feet to buy time. Nowhere to go, and the ball is loose. Well, the offense looks as if they fell on the fumble, and they'll keep the ball. Oh, they are breathing a sigh of relief after that recovered fumble. Feet in the end zone, looking to fire. Going to try to get it himself. They get him on the ground, didn't see anything downfield, but made a little something out of it. You make up the game plan and not a lot on the play sheet for this. Third and long from inside their own 20. All bottled up, and now the ball is free. Everybody needs a little luck, and the offense just got it by falling on that fumble. The Mountaineers decide to punt it away. Three and out, they got stuck in reverse. They hope the punt can bail them out. Hauls it in, looking for space. The speed, the shiftiness, the elusiveness, all on display in that sweet return there. West Virginia has it back, ready to dive into that playbook. They'll leave it with him. Final minute, and they're going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their total.
And this always is the debate of where you fall. It's your job to stop me, or I should get concerned, because this offense obviously has had themselves a day, and apparently their day's not over. They're going to continue to keep scoring, and the defense better do something about it.
He'll bring it out. It's Sanders. And they'll get him on the ground as the offense comes out to start the next drive. They'll try to put something together, backed up a bit, starting at their own 13. They'll throw it on first down. And he will be sacked at the 6-yard line. And now they have enhanced their degree of difficulty on second and long from the 6. Trying to get to it.
The defense puts the exclamation point on the day. They have had a wonderful day, man, doing everything great. Just, you could tell they were dialed into what was going on, and now just throw another sack in the equation, hitting the quarterback.
They come up with their second safety of the game. You don't see that very often. After getting caught for a safety, they're lined up and ready to kick it off.
Oh, and how about this defense? Understanding where they are in the field, they got a chance to put points on the board, and they do.
West Virginia has it in the offense ready to go to work. Barring complete catastrophe, David, this offense ought to be able to salt away this game.
Yeah, and unless you're playing in a different league, this one's over. Like, there is no three-point conversions and stuff like that that you can get. So run the ball, make them use timeouts, Palmer, walk out here with a dub.
Yeah, this defense should just use their timeouts. Can't take them with you, right? And we'll just see. Who knows?
The expressway is wide open. And that's how you finish it off. Scoring on the final play of the game doesn't affect the outcome. Just a little cherry on top of the sundae.
And you knew this one was over already, but how about an exclamation point to go with it? Another score for this offense. They've had themselves a great day, and the stats just continue to pile up.
Just complete and utter dominance in this one. Outplayed.